innocent girls versus non-innocent girls.
Kinks slash fetishes.
Now look, what do y'all think? I want y'all to comment below, because like, this is a very, very important question to me. Why do you think a girl become uninnocent? Like, why? Well, obviously, once you get older, you obviously experience more. You obviously watch things like movies. You obviously hear songs, and there are social media. Which means you have that, you're gonna most likely see all of it. But what is y'all reason? I have a couple reasons, but what is y'all reason? I wanna hear y'all. We're gonna get into something very deep and emotional. We're about to get into something very, very playful and stupid damn funny. All right, let's go. All right, if you're a person out there that's watching this video and you lost your virginity before you turned 18, let's just hope that, you know, you maybe you thought that you was in love with this guy, you know, he's so charming, you know, he's so sweet, and he was just that guy for you. And once you maybe got older, you realize, I'm fucking stupid. But wait, some people just, they don't regret that. They don't regret losing a V card. At the same time, that's what people want to experience.
I was 13 when I lost my virginity.
People do not want to wait until they're 18 or 21 or maybe until marriage. You know, yes, that probably definitely most likely was a thing back then. When our parents was kids, you know, that was more likely something that can happen.
My sweet, I cannot believe today is actually here. In just a few hours, I'll be your wife for life. I love you so much. And I'm so excited to marry you and do life with you.
But now it's damn near impossible. Y'all girls getting pregnant.
Pregnant at 16, teen mom, my story. Pregnant at 14, how I found out I was pregnant. Pregnant at 15, updated, teen mom.
Salute to all the young moms out there. I'm not disrespecting them. I'm just saying, like, you know, you're too young. You got a life to live. 14, 15, 16. Like, damn. I feel like I'd be miserable if I got a girl pregnant if I was that age. Because I'm too young. There's so much stuff that I still really want to do. Now I got to make sure I got to go see my baby. And then I got another baby on top of that. Especially the other baby is my girlfriend. For some of you who's maybe a little bit slow. So, and then not only that, we're young, so we probably don't even really like each other like that. Like, we might fall off at any point. Not only that, I'm gonna want more girls. You think I'm gonna want to commit to one girl at the age of 14? Maybe for a little while, but after a while, sweetheart, we gotta break up. This was just for fun.
What?
Oh shit.
Like, you know, this is just young mind thinking. Not everybody think like this, but majority of relationships that's young like that do not last at all. You know, at the end of it all, it's nothing I can do. You might be like, but Ras, I want it. I want it. You don't want it. Fuck. I need it. Ras, but I need it. You don't need it. You just want it.
Duh.
But Ras, look at my friends. They said it felt good. It was the best thing ever. I want that feeling. I love you. I love you. I'm just trying to protect you. You know, I don't want no F-boy just... And then trying to break your heart or anything, you might as well just wait. No. You know, if you're older, protect your young ones. You know, these F-boys out here is crazy. Crazy. Yes, I want a daughter in the future. I do. You know, I'm going to let my daughter live free. Of course. Of course. But, you know, maybe one day she's going to come home and be like, Dad. You know, because we're going to be that close. My daughter going to feel free to tell me anything.
Really, really, really?
She's going to be like, Dad? I'm going to be like, yes, sweetheart. She gonna be like, I lost my virginity. I'm gonna be like, just give me a hug for telling me the truth. That's all I care about. Because look, at the end of the day, if I get pissed off at my daughter for telling me that, you're gonna keep things away from me. I'm gonna try to train my daughter to be as, you know, as possible. But when that time comes, when she's just ready to go out there to do that, I gotta be like, damn. Hopefully it's not at like 15, 14, 13, 16, you know, because that at that age, having sex so much will fuck you up, literally, mentally, relationship-wise. It will mess you up. Somehow you think you need that, it just mess you up. But let's just say that that happens for my daughter. You know what? Try to not make her go out here thotting around, but at the same time, I'm not gonna get mad at her. What I'm saying is, I'm just trying to protect y'all, you know? I'm just leading y'all with this information and y'all do whatever y'all want with it, because it's nothing I can do. I'm just a person through the screen. Maybe I'm going to see y'all one day and, you know, we all could be at Disney World having the time of our life. All right, let's jump into this real topic though that we was been supposed to talk about, but I got out of topic.
No one ever really sat me down and taught me about boundaries or taught me that it was okay to say no and to turn down sex. I almost felt like it was my duty to have sex with my boyfriends. I had this deep down feeling and fear that if I turned them down, then that they wouldn't love me anymore, that I wouldn't be worthy or deserving of their love, and that ultimately they would just end up going and cheating on me.
No, she just getting real deep, sending information. She felt like she had no choice. It's only the beginning. Hold up. Let's hit them with a little bit more sauce.
By having sex against my will and not keeping strong boundaries, it caused me to disconnect from myself even more.
Now, I hope y'all mature, because this about to get something for this, you know, mature. I hope y'all mature.
And being a young girl, I didn't know how to handle it, and so many, many times I just ended up enduring the sex because I felt like I had no choice. And what ended up actually happened by having sex against my will and not keeping strong boundaries, it caused me to disconnect from myself even more.
Because she was doing it against her will. Which means, okay, let's just say 50% of her wanted it and 50% of her didn't. Like, she let herself into him half in.
Someone tried to touch me, no. Someone wanted to take me home, no. Someone to have sex with me, no. It was so easy to say no, like, so easy. As soon as it's someone that you're in love with, you become more frightened, more terrified to say no, because deep down for me anyway, I believed that in me saying no, there was a chance that I was going to lose this person.
All right, now here's where it gets interesting, because if you say no and he does not care what you say, he don't care about your boundaries, he showed his true colors. He don't care about how you feel. He just want what he want. You might be in love, so you're gonna let your love get the best of you. It be like that. And you're gonna just let yourself in and give him what he want. You just wanna wild out and go crazy like that. It's gonna feel like nothing. It's gonna feel like nothing is wrong. And, you know, everything's gonna feel perfectly fine. Like, I'm living my best damn life. What's the worst that can happen? Like, let's be honest, I don't care. In the long run, it's gonna mess you up. It's gonna mess you up. If you say no, you in love, he can't handle it, then he gotta go. If you let yourself in and you just like, I don't wanna lose him, then no.
Ah! Fuck!
I don't know what to say. I'm just trying to help y'all out. I just want y'all to live y'all best life, have a healthy relationship life, you know, have a safe life. I don't want y'all to be depressed because of these boys. You know, I just really want y'all to live good.
So it's hard.
This shit is hard. But y'all get what I'm trying to say, though? Y'all get it? But I'm gonna end this video off with this. There's a chance that, you know, so many people, boys and girls that age, that already lost their V-card. Because regardless of what I say, you know, you're going to want to do what you're going to want to do. If you did not yet, and you don't want to listen to me, in a couple of years, come back to this video. Not even, maybe in a couple of months. Why? I'm not gonna tell you why. You're gonna see why. You're gonna learn the hard way if you wanna keep going out there. Just, now maybe you'd be like, Ras, but I'm in a relationship, it's different. I can understand that. Like, oh, I'm in a relationship, so you know, we in love. But trust me, it's totally, completely different when you're young. I promise you. But like I said, you the person that don't want to listen to me. So you like, damn, I do, but I just can't listen to you because I want it so bad. So you know what? Come back a couple years and watch this video. It's gonna hit you hard and it's gonna hit you deep. You the person that have done it, you're gonna listen to me. Here's where it's gonna get boring because you're gonna be like, I can't help it. That's me. Your love life, mental thinking, it's gonna be tremendously, what's that word? Tremendous. It's gonna be fantastic. You're gonna be so much different from all of these other girls out there. You're gonna be thinking different, moving different. You're gonna be more independent. You're gonna be okay to feel lonely. You're gonna be really okay to feel lonely. You gotta realize this. Most girls who sin, I'm about to get deep. Y'all probably hate me for this. Most girls who send nudes, most girls who like wild out all the time, they feel hurt badly, a lot. Why? Because so much guys just mess over them and they get so used to getting messed over, it becomes a normal thing. Why? Because you letting yourself in too much.